I built my first instrument in 1971, and I built over 100. I kind of lost count. The Italian word for harpsichord was gravicimbalo, big harpsichord. And they called the piano gravicimbalo con forte e piano, big harpsichord with loud and soft, because the first pianos were basically harpsichords. But instead of a mechanism that plucked the string, a little hammer was put on the end of the string. It caught an escape button and just flipped it up. So you were able with that to press hard and get a loud sound, press softly and get a soft sound, which you can't do with the harpsichord. You press, you get what you get. It's all one sound. So the addition of the hammer allowed the player to control forte a piano. I think the most rewarding is that after everything is built and the soundboard is in and all the strings are put on, you really have no idea what it's going to sound like. And when you start, you get the jacks made and the little plectra in there, it's when you start pressing the key and hearing a sound. That's the most interesting. When the quills pluck the strings, they're much too thick, and it's raucous and it's explosive. And you have to quiddle, carve gently those little plectra to bring the sound into focus. And it's bringing the sound to life. That's what I find most rewarding.
the continuo is something that was very specific to Baroque music, to Baroque playing, usually comprised of two instruments, one that plays the bass notes and another one that realizes the figured bass or fills in the chords. On the bass line, it could be a double bass, it could be a cello, it could be a bassoon, it could be a trombone, it could be... And then filling the chords, it could be an organ, it could be a piano, it could be a harpsichord. That's your foundation, that's a harmonic outline. And that way, everybody who's playing melodic lines doesn't have to worry so much about, like, presenting the right chord structure. They stay within that chord structure when they ornament, but we are the ones giving the outline of the music.
Thank you. I think the cool thing about Baroque music is that at the time the instruments were much more limited. So the harpsichord doesn't have pedals, it doesn't really have dynamics, and the same was true of the woodwind instruments and the string instruments.
You're not going to be able to like make a crescendo or diminuendo. I mean, the way you make contrast on the harpsichord is a lot with articulation and timing.
So we're finding in rehearsal that we actually have to be fairly creative with how to figure out diversity and variety within the music.
Thank you. about placing it as opposed to taking more time. Bum, 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 yeah, bum, bum.
I feel like every time I do a Baroque program, it's like rediscovering the genre. And playing with, you know, Marilyn is here playing cello, playing with a string player who knows so much about the style and how Baroque instruments were played, she always reminds me of stylistic things that we can do to improve the music. And with oboe, we're very interested in long phrases and sustaining notes, and she reminded us that the piece needs to breathe a little bit more. When there's long sustained notes, we need to come away from them a little bit and let the other music come through.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.